to the blue line. Breslick just missed. And an interference call, and Jake McCabe is, well, he ought to get two minors in this sequence.
And he just might. The referees want to get the extra on that late hit after the whistle, after the original penalty on McCabe. It was an interference call on Jake DeBrusque behind the goal line. Again, the Bruins clean exit out of the defensive zone. D to D, McAvoy, Grizzlick, and then a nice little soft dump in. The goaltender can't handle it. You get into your forechecking game. Toronto miscue on their breakout attempt. I believe it was Matthews with the backhand feed out of the middle of the defensive zone. Now the Bruins get a shot just wide, and then the pressure behind the goal where you want to make Toronto have to play should lead to a Bruin power play.
Francis Chiron and Jake Brink are the referees. Interference was called before the whistle, and then Jake McCabe trucked Marchand. So we have a threshold to set.
Yeah, they're trying to get it right, and that's why they're having a discussion amongst the three of them. Got to keep one linesman on the other side, make sure nothing happens over there between the Bruins and the Leafs.
Discussion rivaling the length of the Paris peace talks.
Toronto's penalties, original number 22, 2 minutes for interference. Number 23 gets 2 minutes for roughing.
Ah, nice.
Well, we're going to look. This is your interference call on McCabe. Obviously, DeBrusque nowhere near that puck or reacting, trying to get to the puck. And then Marchand comes in. And I see that as McCabe again, Jack, as you pointed out.
Player safety ought to look at this because that resembled Morgan Riley's 5-game suspension, uncalled for, high stick. Crosschecks to the neck. Oh, jeez.
Yeah, that's
he
nasty.
He caught a little nasty sweater, but Jake McCabe. Here's Riley's hit. Both were after the whistle. 5-on-3 for Boston. Pasternak blocked. McAvoy taps to Marchand. Pasternak tries to feed Van Riemsdyk.